Alright, welcome back. We have time for probably one more episode, maybe two if we end up going on a roll. But this is episode 42. Did I just say that? I might have just said that. Either way, we are going to quick travel to this camp here, Driftwood Margin Camp. And then we're going to head northwest and explore the last area of the Storm Coast.
Inquisitor.
Do you have any tasks for me, or do I have a task to turn in? I don't really remember at this point. I think I have enough Elkroot to turn things in. I do. Don't want to spend it on this. Probably shouldn't, but I'm going to. I do like that influence XP. Alright, what else you got?
Dispatch for you.
What is it?
This could help us.
Cotton and Deepstalker hide. Perfect, have those. Guess all those Deepstalkers I had paid off. You think at some point we'd be running out of ships to salvage, but game doesn't work that way.
Word for you.
What is it?
This could help us.
What is it? More geology? Getting lots of influence. So each individual quest doesn't give much, but they do add up.
I've news, sir.
What is it?
Could prove useful, sir.
Nope, back to Anti-Venom. Okay, so always the Anti-Venom. I actually kind of want to go on this way and see what's down here. Probably the edge of the map. There is a pillar up there, I guess, but you probably can't go up there. Well, maybe you can, because on the other side of the hill is just more map. I don't really want to go over that way. I want to eventually go up over this way. I guess we should have Varric here to get the approval rating, but I don't really care that much. So there is a set of steps over here. I'm just not sure it goes anywhere really useful. So we've been over here, it looks like. Okay. Let's actually, you know what? Since we're right at the camp anyway, let's go here and grab Varric. Just get some XP from him, or some approval from him.
Nothing to report.
Alright. Varric, there you are. And Blackwall. Vivian. There's a bear attacking camp. You could report that. He's not really attacking, he's kind of just wandering. I always feel bad attacking creatures that are attacking me first. But he would attack me first, so I got too close, so there's that. Alright, so we are heading over this direction. I don't know if we've been through that cave or not. I don't think we have. I think the cave was like where we stopped. So we'll come back here later. And now is later, so that's what we'll do. So we pretty much explored the entire coast in a single day. A day with a lot of playtime, but still just a single day. See, again, just the way the graphics are, it looks like snow, but it's not. Just a weird lighting effect of it. I don't know if we should go up there or not. Let's head down for now. We can always go up if we need to. Well, maybe not easily, but if we need to go up, we can find a way up. Some black lotus. It's a big plant. There's some more back there, but I don't care. It's getting rather late. But I'd like to fight this dragon. What's that? Before I go to bed. I heard a roar or something. That, you hear it? I don't know if it's a sound effect or... Alright, so this is like already here. Ah, it's like a camp. Some loots. What is this? Oh, just gold. Alright, well. Still a cool little area. Oh, what is that? That is a rock. Okay, I thought it was like a dwarven door or something built into the side of the cliff, but guess not. Anything up there? There's a dwarven thing right there. But I guess we have to go in the front way. Like normal people. Something down there too, I see. Maybe that's the cave up ahead? So this door might be shut, actually. Maybe this isn't anything after all. This is probably the entrance to the deep roads the dwarves came from, but of course it was sealed and collapsed long ago. Possibly to prevent the darkspawn from getting in and out when the dwarves abandoned it in ancient times during the first blight. Maybe even before the first blight, actually, because I guess the first blight wouldn't have happened until they'd already been digging a while and found the first archdemon. Okay, so it's a little... Somebody's been here, definitely. It's lit up. Is this door shut? I mean, it is, obviously. But how do we get it open? Can we go around? It doesn't look like it. I may have to look up something online to see how to get that door open, because... Honestly, not sure. What am I missing here? There's no side passage. It's not even a door, it's just like a wall, essentially. There's a door drawn into it, but it might as well be that dwarven door. There's nothing to click on or anything. Is that a bug? Probably not. Maybe we can go around up here after all? Yeah, some darkspawn. Good time to leave. So I didn't think you could go around up here, but there's gotta be a way. Because there's stuff up there. Obviously. Maybe up there? Let's try over here, and if not, then I might look up to see what exactly the deal is with that door that doesn't actually exist. No, it's not as steep as it looked at first. Although it might as well be, because I think there's an invisible wall here. Come on, keep jumping! Okay, we made it to here. Here. Can we jump over to here? No. Just get rebuked. That's the door. And that's the invisible wall. Alright, well. Yeah, I want to get those things. So, what is this called? The Storm Coast? Just going to look it up. I don't have time to be wandering around all day hoping to find something. I guess we haven't explored over there yet, but if that's where we're supposed to be going, then we'll find out in 1 second. So I'm going to go west of the Storm Coast. Yep, here we go. Sealed cave at end of Storm Coast. Seems like I'm not the only one that is wondering about it. You did deal with constellations. Yeah. Oh, apparently you need to do something in a war room quest first. Alright. So I guess we'll have to come back here later then, and I'm assuming the dragon is in that zone. As are some of our... So 3 lyrium mains. 4 of them actually are there. So apparently that's all that's there. I guess we found all the relics already. Well, we'll come back there later then. I guess for now we're done with the Storm Coast. I'm not sure where that dragon was. I'm going to assume in there too, and if he's not there once we do that war table mission, then I'll look it up then, but that's going to be the assumption for now. Let's go down and explore that other area real quick, since we're already in the neighborhood. And unless we attack by a dragon there, we are going to leave the zone and probably do some war table stuff, because I want to get my specialization, and I'd like to unlock that cave eventually. Not sure if we have access to it quite yet. Something's over there, maybe. Probably just some loot or something. Yep. That's exactly what it was. probably go to a merchant too while we're in Skyhold. I almost said Haven there, but Haven is a haven no more. Spin the lead. A little bit further to clear up the map. And then we'll consider this place fully explored. At least for the time being. Elf root. I like how I'm so happy to see the most common crafting material in the game, but never thought I'd get rid of that stockpile I had, but upgrading potions does that to you. Another grass ship to salvage. Hello, seagull or pelican, whatever you are. I guess it's seagull. Alright. Everyone say goodbye to the Storm Coast. We will be back later. See, it's like frothing over. It's weird looking. Alright. Anyway. That's it for now. Let's head back to the world map. And so yeah, basically there's nowhere for us to go until we do the next worm quest anyway. Which we probably won't do today, probably tomorrow morning. But we'll see, because I don't really know what else there is to do. And so far this episode is only 11 minutes long. So maybe we'll do some main quest today. If I would have known that, I probably would have just gone to bed, but I assume there was a whole section over here to explore, as well as a dragon fight, which I wanted to do. Alright, so we also have to judge the prisoner. Maybe we'll do that first. There's still a lot to do in Skyhold. How you doing, Sarah? I'll meet her a bit. Hard to understand her, but
well,
she
about
disapproves
time you
to
came
her.
Around to talk, innit? Sign me up, then not so much as a welcome. Little busy, I hope, making sure this new place can keep out a pissing archdemon. And the thing controlling it, that we're hunting. Draste, what do I step in?
Yeah, I'm very busy, thank you. I am the Inquisitor. I have 9 companions, I can't babysit them all. I have other things to do, like recruit another companion and defend the coast against all manner of evil.
Odd that you'd ask Andraste over your own gods.
Our
my
own
gods? Whatever. They don't talk any more than she does. Not like she's supposed to. I know what happened to you, or what everyone here thinks happened. It seems... I don't know what it seems.
Convenient?
The ancient thing trying to kill us seems pretty real.
Don't get me started. Oh, wait. Too late, right? A magister who cracked the Black City. It's a hazy dream, right? I mean, if it's real, then the seat of the Maker? Real thing. A seat needs a butt, so the Maker? Real thing. Fairy stories about the start and end of the world? Real things. It's too far, isn't it? I just want to plug the Skyhole rubbish so I can go play.
Well, we did plug the Skyhole before you actually got here. And I did that because I wasn't standing around talking to every single person in my team.
You joined to help the little people caught up in this. But do you believe or not?
In Andraste? Of course.
But you doubt what you're seeing and hearing.
It can't be true. Even fanatics don't want to be this right. Look, I have arrows. I can make this Corypheus believe in those. Good enough?
Yeah, these good luck good with that. I guess I'll try to build her up because she's not like doubting herself. Like she's just not a pessimist.
I'm fighting magisters. I need you aiming higher than simple selfishness.
Lumpy wants to be a god, and you glow or something. I just want to fix things so I don't have to think about what's real or not. High enough, my lady.
I don't know what it is. I just really don't like her. I guess cause she's like, I don't know, anti-intellectual. Like she's trying not to think about things, but like, and I'm the exact opposite. I love thinking about everything I can possibly think about. And she's just like, oh no, I wanted to shoot things so my head can stop hurting from all of this thought. And you can romance her too, apparently. I don't like any of these choices. I don't want to flirt with her. I'm not really sure she is making sense. She doesn't really believe in, like, she believes in elven faith, but not this kind of faith. And I don't want to call her crazy either. I don't like any of these. I guess I'll go with this one.
Belief may decide what happens. You can't rule it out.
Right, well, shout me up when the gods show. I'll be here, loony.
Well, one who already thinks he's a god did show. We just have to prove him wrong. Alright, I'll talk to her a little more, even though I don't really want to.
Demon armies and wardens, and Varric has exactly who we need. The big talker just knows everything.
Tell me about yourself.
What about me?
You're skilled. Who taught you how to use a bow?
No one.
That seems unlikely.
What? I picked it up here and there. Mostly it just makes sense. It's not like that for you.
Only when I'm boasting.
Oh, like certainly. That. Not a day's effort for the naturally gifted like us.
Well, it's not like that. It takes work. A bit. Not like Cullen and his pets. I mean, you miss, then you don't. Is it that hard to see when it's wrong?
Well, it's not like that for other elves, I know that.
Most I know couldn't find an arrow sitting on it. Right. Maybe I just make it look easy in shite company. Fact still is, no teacher. Where would I find one in alleyways, anyway?
How about the basics? Where are you from?
Ferelden.
I got that from the accent. Where in Ferelden?
All over? Okay, fine. Denimrim for a bit. South, north, wherever I want.
Oh, you're from wherever. I'm from north wherever.
What?
North wherever. Oh, we had fun on street and all in local tavern.
I love that.
Oh, hardy ha. Oh, funny you. It's complicated. I don't like complicated. Let's leave it at that. Maybe.
I like this choice.
I'm just interested in talking to an elf like me.
She's not really like you, though.
I think so.
Why not?
Well, maybe you're all right. But most elves are too... elfy. Like that Solus, right? Never be as good as we were. Well, who's we? I'm just fine.
There's a lot of tradition there. Should it just be thrown away?
Your great-grandfather's dead. Why aren't you dead? You're throwing away tradition.
That makes sense to you.
None of it does in the city. That's why I'm not like an elf.
Alrighty then.
We'll talk later.
That's enough Sarah for one day.
If you say so.
Let's see. I guess down to the dungeons. I assume that what's his name is down there, Alexius. We can decide his fate. I like how she's like skipping along all merrily going down to the dungeons. Very elf-like, I guess. Maybe I have to talk to the guard and talk to him? Because I don't actually see anybody in these cells. And there's no cells over there. Where is this place? I guess I didn't check all of these, but is he actually in one of them? I'm gonna keep him in this cell, it's too hard to get to. Somebody would die bringing him his food. And these cells are mostly caved in. Yeah, I don't see any Alexius. Not very realistic. Alright, so maybe we have to talk to the guard then to find him.
Your worship, the cells are ready for the enemies of the Inquisition. Good facilities in Skyhold. Whoever built this knew how to keep prisoners safe but secure.
Maybe not. Okay, so let's make this our actual quest then. Alright, so we can do Hawk's Quest, we can head to the War Room to talk about the Winter Palace Ball. Specializations, there we go. Seek out combat trainers at the War Table. I'm going to do that one in a bit. But, that's for Cassandra, that's for Cullen, right? Yeah, much like the Inquisition, Corypheus has invested great time and effort building a trusted inner circle. Samson is a former Templar, Illyrium addict, and now the leader of the Red Templars. Cullen knows Samson well, and believes intercepting caravans, smuggling Red Lyrium, and the Emerald Graves could get the Inquisition closer to taking him down. Okay. Wonder who the rest of Corypheus' inner circle is. Emerald Graves, the new area, I guess. But we probably have to scout that area first, like the others. Skyhold. No. We still haven't found the blacksmith yet. Sit in judgment, there it is. Judge the prisoner. Alright, so he's actually not in the dungeon, because that would just make too much sense. How are we in the middle area? There's an area below this? Alright. Maybe we'll actually get to explore the elven ruins beneath this place? That'd be kind of cool. As long as it's not the deep roads. But we are kind of high up in the mountains to have access to the deep roads. Alright, so I guess the prisoner is way up here? No, that's something else. We do have to turn that one map we found into Blackwell, though.
How do you
though.
Know they won't attack here?
Darkspawn, don't think.
So I guess we go over here to talk about the prisoner.
It's looking good. Not good enough, but good.
Doesn't make sense, but okay. Oh, you sit on the throne to make judgments. That's a very scary looking throne. I'm not sure I really like that. It's not really fitting for somebody who's the leader of the Inquisition. It'd be more like for an Archon or something. A Tementor Magister.
Impressive, is it not? Fit for a leader, meant to show influence and the burden of it. It is where the Inquisition will sit in judgment. Where you will sit in judgment.
I just think it looks weird.
Who will I be judging exactly?
Those who have done wrong. You will know of them, at the very least. All this presumes they have survived their initial encounter with you, of course.
I like that they give that choice there and don't just... You spare somebody instead of killing them, so they take them away and you never see them again.
Will we be taking heads right here in the hall?
Goodness, no! If such an option is available, it will be done elsewhere. And it may not be necessary. The Inquisition's sovereignty is derived from the allies who validate it. You are both empowered and bound. Justice has many tools. If their application is clever, execution may even seem merciful by comparison.
I actually kind of like her hair. It doesn't seem like it's one of the hairdos available to the player, though.
Is there anyone I should judge?
Take the throne when you're ready. We will bring him before you.
Alexius. I could do like the confirmation thing, and then I still have to sit on the throne anyway. Like I just did 2 minutes ago.
This was a surprise. After you return from the bogs, we discovered this man attacking the building with a goat. Chief Movran the Under. He feels slighted by the killing of his Avar tribesmen, who repeatedly attacked you first. What should we do with him? Where should he go?
With a goat. Yeah, let's see what he has to say for himself.
You're a chieftain of the Avar. Will your attacks persist?
A courtroom? Unnecessary. You killed my idiot son, and I answered, as is my custom, by smacking your holdings with goat's blood.
It's quite a voice he has. Could be a
demon
or something.
Don't look at me.
No foul. He meant to murder Tventus, but got feisty with your Inquisition. A red-headed mother guarantees a brat. Do as you've earned, Inquisitor.
Will you pick the mother?
My clan yields. My remaining boys have brains still in their heads.
So the goat was a tradition and not a threat? I'm confused. Yeah, I'd say just drive them out.
I don't have time for idiots. Let's get this over with. Chief Movran, crimes, etc. You and your people just get out.
That sounds like her.
Push us out. You've earned it. Have fun with whoever we push back.
Is that it? Thrones found, 2 of 21. Oh, the collections they put in this game. I want to judge Alexius, though.
You recall Garion Alexius of
Tevinter,
Ferelden has given him to us as an acknowledgement of your aid.
How kind
the formal charges are apostasy, attempted enslavement, and attempted assassination on your own life, no less. Tevinter has disowned and stripped him of his rank. You may judge the former magister as you see fit.
Is that sarcasm? The apostasy sticks out?
I remember what would have happened to Thedas if his treachery had succeeded.
I couldn't save my son. Do you think my fate matters to me?
Will you offer nothing more in your defense?
You've won nothing. The people you saved, the acclaim you've gathered. You'll lose it all in the storm to come. Render your judgment, Inquisitor.
You're not making this easy, not being repentant at all. So you do have some interesting choices, though. You can make him tranquil. Oh, because you're a mage, you get that choice. That's interesting. That's an interesting thought. See, I might have gone with that, except... see, Hawk met Tranquil, who was temporarily untranquilled by Anders. And he claimed he would rather die than go back to being a Tranquil, which might mean it's not as nice a fate as the Tranquil themselves would have you believe. We could have him researching your magic. That's a cool icon. Oh, excuse me. I'm not sure what that actually means, though. We'll serve Redcliff as mages. That seems too dangerous. I hope these would actually have repercussions, too. Like, if that happens, he'd actually could do something bad or maybe something good. We could just imprison him till the end of his days. But I don't want him just, you know, drawing on our resources by feeding him and keeping guards on him and all that. I'd rather he try to do some good.
Your magic was theoretically impossible, Alexius. I could use people like you. Your sentence is to serve under guard as a researcher on all things magical for the Inquisition.
Under guards experienced in magic.
Very well.
Everyone approves and disapproves. That's kind of cool. Or slightly approves and slightly disapproves. Alright. Are there any more? We can do one more, I guess. Nope, no more. Right? No. Okay. So now what? Talk to those three in the tower. What I really want to find is the Armorsmith and the Undercroft. Is the Undercroft right next to me? Ah, there it is. Oh, a new zone, I guess.
Better and better.
Storage.
What can't we...
Oh, that's cool. We have storage. I don't think I need it for anything quite yet, but that's nice that it's there. Which reminds me, we do have to harden Hightown Chapter 6. We do have to sell off our items. Tint armor. Does this mean you can change the color of it? Maybe. Maybe not this item, though. Alright, I'm not gonna mess with this yet. That is cool that you can actually color your armor. I like that a lot. Buy and sell. Do you buy... Oh, this is that. Okay. Your respec thing. We have a new free respec, but... Oh, I do want to put Dispel back on my bar, though. I think what happened is whatever ability is in your one spot gets overridden by your special spell. Oh, there's the special Inquisitor tree. Successfully performing an ability combo or an additional focus for the party. I'm not going to go for that. I haven't really looked into ability combos yet. I like combos a lot, so I'd like to, but I don't know, I just haven't found the time. Okay, so I want to take my existing spell, which is Dispel, and put that back as number one. Alright, there we go. Parrot, how are you?
I've walked away from too many burning buildings for one lifetime.
You're telling me?
This place, though, it'll be alright.
Probably won't burn.
It's Inquisitor now, isn't it? That'll take some getting used to.
Yeah, you can just tell me. Call me whatever, I don't care.
You think it's strange to say. It's stranger to hear.
Don't let it go to your head. We need you level. Everyone just got a big hard reason to hate Corypheus. And we already did, but we didn't have a name. You did what you could, I suppose.
How is this place shaping up as a forge?
Better than Haven ever could be. Good. Not the way I wanted an upgrade, but ever forward.
An optimist, I like him.
Have you any thoughts about the people we lost at Haven?
Yes.
Care to share?
No. It hurts, and I don't want to spit on your efforts. You saved who you could. We have to be happy with that.
I wonder if there were more you could have saved if I had done something different. I did a couple of those little bonus quests. I didn't see any more of them, but I didn't really take time to explore in all the chaos. So I was trying to be, like, realistic and actually beeline towards our goals.
You've got it all up and running.
Your basics, like always. There's space here for... I don't know what.
I love
this
I don't know what.
This place was built for something big. It'll be a job to fill it.
It sounds like you actually can by doing various quests and things.
Later.
So that'll be a cool objective.
I'll be here.
To really make Skyhold your own. I'm looking forward to it. And in a way, that's one of the cool things of doing a Let's Play, is normally this wouldn't be as exciting because, unlike an MMO, nobody's ever going to see your stronghold you build. But because it's a video, people actually will. So here's how you customize it, I guess, with banners, beds, drapery. You can get a new throne. Okay, good. So we have the Inquisition throne. What else do we find? We found one throne. So that's why it's a collection. Legacy. Okay, this is because we imported the other games. I want to see what they look like. And we have a chastened throne we found somewhere. We can do the windows a different way. Let's do Inquisition for now. I'd like to have some Dalish thrones. That'd be cool. Or Dalish stuff. A Dalish and mage theme, I think, would be appropriate for my character. For my Inquisitor. Alright, so here's all of our normal crafting stations. I'm not going to do too much crafting this episode, or any really, because I just don't want to get into it right now. So I think we already did the... Okay, there's a merchant there that we can sell stuff to. I should probably upgrade everybody again before selling all this stuff, but I'm going to assume they're all right for now. I'll keep that, though. A lot of this stuff I'm going to have to just start selling. Because I'm not going to wear spirit defense. Or 2% magic defense. We have 3 of these guys. 4 of these guys, rather. I don't use life orb that much. Because I can sell this. I don't need it for anything else. Probably not going to use that either. Although we did have some people who didn't have any belts at all. So maybe I should have kept those. Whatever. We'll find more. I think I have Bianca arms something like higher, but we'll see. Armor. Is this all the armor we have left? Okay. Weapons. Dreamweaver staff. Now I have that song stuck in my head. That's not that good. Again, I would attempt to sing it, but with this cold, it's not going to end well, so not going to bother. Great axe. The one he has is better. Get a lot of weapons in this game. Alright. 15. Very nice. Might just use this to sell all my stuff, because then I can... Can I buy it back? No. Can't actually buy it back. That's okay, though. Didn't want any of it anyway. So... What's left? That's the upgrade, and that's also the blacksmith, which were the last two areas we're supposed to find. Rune crafting. That's at the war table. Alright, so let's, head to the war table then. We'll probably finish up the episode and the day there. But there is a lot I want to do at the war table. To unlock new zones on the world map, among other things. Oh, quarters. Oh, these are my quarters. I wonder if the door was locked. I guess you can upgrade this area too. That's kind of cool. Can I jump down there? I was admiring,
They have certainly spared no expense.
Really? I wonder if Sol's paying that. I was admiring Cullen's office, but I think mine might take the cake. Oh, some recipes. Recipe main watchtower. I guess that's for upgrading the keep then. Oh, you can make a better garden if you have more. Okay. I'll just start saving some Melford for that. A better courtyard. I like that. The idea of collecting materials as we go and putting them to use, making your own. Oh, we can even change. Cat. Oh, are there different types of wear? I guess this is what I wear when I'm in Skyhold casual wear. Seems like it's the same, but different coloring. That's too white. Eh, we can go with this one just for something different. Formal wear, is that what you wear to specialized occasions, I guess? Is it going to show me, though? Oh, it does, while you're in your bedroom, okay. That's an interesting look. I don't want to play dress-up all day, but I do want to see what these at least look like. The Callenhad Sunset. Interesting names. So they're kind of the same, but different colors by the looks of it. Yeah. Yeah, let's go with the Callenhad Sunset. Outerwear. I don't know what this is even for. Or is it... Is this all what you wear at the place? In Skyhold. Oh, I actually kind of like that, even though it's more warriorish. It's very shiny. It's different. Shame there's only two armor types. Let's go with that. So that's kind of like Shepherd's Closet in Normandy. Oh, and I have a view! I do love a room with a view. Actually, this isn't bad either. There's the green area, so we can rebuild the courtyard, I guess. And as an architect, I love courtyards, so we will definitely be putting some effort into that. Not a bad view either over the icy lake. It's really quite beautiful. They did a good job, I say. Oh, is this just the loft? Might just be the loft. Yeah, not the top of the tower. Those are the views. What's up here, though? Maybe you can build something up here? Not really sure. Alright, it's kind of more space than I think I need, especially being a Dalish. She's used to sleeping in Aravails and tents and all. But it is nice, I'll give him that. Alright, but I did want to go to the war table before I got distracted. I like the armor actually clinks, that's cool. Can I jump down here? Oh, I can't, I was all excited to jump off the ledge. Oh well. I like how it is sort of like run down though, like the other story building. That's cool. If you just came in, everything was all perfect and pristine, that would seem out of place. But anyway, I meant to go over here. I think. Yes, this is the war room. So we have a lot to do in here. Yeah, definitely a lot of work to do around this castle to make it fully functional, but it's good to have tasks to rise to. Alright, we do have an Inquisition perk. Again, lots of good ones. I can probably go straight for, I can, get an extra combat ability point, which I really want, but I think I might get the Codex ones first, because the earlier you take them, the more benefit you're going to get.
We cannot neglect our soldiers' training.
Thank you,
can
Colin.
Can we neglect roads? Our allies cannot take the same route through two. The mountains we did.
I guess I have knowledge of what? I already have underworld knowledge. And I have history and I have magic, so all I don't have then is nobility. But I guess because I am preparing to deal with Orlais and go to a ball, we'll say that I spent some time reading up and now have nobility knowledge, which actually might come in handy since I'll be dealing with nobility soon. Most of the rest of these I don't really care about. Wonder where, I guess magic probably? What's magic under? Secrets? There he is, a magister in disgrace. Alright. That's good, because we need more people for this category, I think, to unlock some of these other ones. Although a lot of these are ones that are nice to have, but not really mandatory. Like Forward Scouts, for example. Still don't really know what a keep is, but we'll find out soon enough. Or who's, is it, are keeps things that are manned by Calpheus's people? We're still not really sure what his people are yet, besides like random demons that used to come from rifts and these Templars that serve him. Other than that, he doesn't really seem that threatening now that the breach is closed. Alright. Back to the map, though. We have lots of power, 93 power. Hopefully there's not a cap. So I'd like to make sure I have... Well, first we have things, yeah. Report ready. Got some gold from that. And there was one more that should be ready. Where was it? Report ready. Some influence from Cullen, thank you. Specializations for the Inquisitor. Instructions for the legions who want to join. Can we inspect the Inquisitor to remain a leader while training with a subordinate? Promoting a specialist from within the ranks seems lacking. Looking outside for the best combat specialist to be found, regardless of their affiliation. So only your corresponding person can do that. So Liliana for rogues, Cullen for warriors, and Josephine for mages.
At your service.
Let's do it. I guess she just did it instantaneously. Works for me. Okay, so Storm Coast. Yes, I want to scout the Storm Coast. I completed that already. Is there something else that can be done here? Reports of Darkspawn activity. Yep, there are reports of Darkspawn activity on the Storm Coast. While the area is sparsely populated, the Darkspawn poses a significant threat to travelers. Sounds like a job for Cullen.
To work?
For Cullen. What's this? An offer from the Blades of Asarian. So they could give us supplies if we send somebody there to get them. Let them keep their supplies, but give us knowledge. Ooh, interesting. We can't take stolen goods, but we could discreetly take found goods. Ever the diplomat. I'm gonna have Liliana do it though, because whatever they find is probably not as useful as knowledge, which could be like, might just be influence, but it could be experience, it could be another quest that opens up, something cool like that. Or the location of a hidden cache somewhere. Find the warden. Hawk is warden or wardens? The Darkspawn brings them under his sway, he'll command a legion of highly skilled warriors. So okay, this is, yeah. This is finding, what's his name. So we'll do that one, probably in the near future, but not right now. Hinterland Resources, what is that? Elfrud and Onyx, we could send her to get them. So he wants the Onyx and Drakestone. Liliana wants the healing herbs. I want the healing herbs too, because Elfrud is good. But Red Jenny, Inquisition needs bees. Jar of bees, okay. Sarah has scribbled a jar of bees hitting someone in the face, also a butt. Yeah, she reminds me a little of, like, kind of Jar Jar Binks vibe. Alright, Josephine, do your magic. And then, so what do we have as the main quest? Mainly the Orlais one over here, right? Yeah. We might want to travel to that temple out west. Maybe not right away, but not in the too distant future. So I'm going to let them do their thing. And I'm probably going to get some sleep in the meantime. But it's been a good day of playing Dragon Age, and I should have some time, maybe not as much time, but some time to play tomorrow as well. So we'll see how that goes. And I'll learn my specialization, so I'm looking forward to that. If this loading screen ever ends, that is. Oh, what is this? Who is that? That looks like Fiona, but who's... I like the mage's robes. They're kind of like the ones in Origins, but I like them. Somebody's ready to... Josephine's already ready to report in, but... Who was that? I mean, what was that cutscene about?
Inquisitor.
It's not you guys. Where's the gate? They came in over here, I guess. I was about to go to bed. Wait for me. Commander Helene. C even though they're kind of like the robes, they're exactly like the robes in the first game, I kind of like those. I don't love them, but they're better, honestly, than anything I've seen so far in this game, so. Maybe I can find some at some point.
Hold and declare, Inquisitor.
What do you mean?
I ask your intent. I was summoned to...
Oh, the trainers.
Training, and I would know my charge.
Right, that makes sense.
I am your commander in this matter. Commander Helaine.
This isn't a formal position. Why treat it so seriously?
She's talking to a pole.
Because that is what it requires and deserves, recruit. I teach the skills of the Knight Enchanter. It is a rank. It is a life. Understanding its hierarchy is the first step. You already know this. You were not made Inquisitor and then taught to lead. I will teach you how to rise to your place. How to join your warriors, spectral blade in hand. How to command the ranks while standing beside them. Are you ready?
Yeah, not really, but I guess I can't. I don't really want this one. Let's ask her a question.
Commander
though.
Is a title I associate with human forces.
Knight Enchanter has roots in elven tradition, but it has the utility warriors. In every tradition. There are no borders for the mage who wields a spectral blade. There is respect, and there is fear.
Who granted your rank? What forces have you served with?
I cannot say.
Then how do I know you're capable?
You know because I have told you, and I will teach you the same authority.
Tell me why this would best suit me.
I cannot. Only you know if you are fit to lead with more than maps. Do you have it's the metal to raise a blade in grand melee? To have your presence make heroes of your charges? This is a path for leaders. You tell me if you are worthy.
I'm pretty sure you just can learn all of them and only actually specialize in one. But I'm going to, just in case, leave the conversation and make sure I do the Rift Mage one first.
I can't commit to this yet.
Alright, so I am actually going to end the episode here now that I know who those people are. And I will talk to... I'll just call your trainer. She's called your trainer. She's called Commander Helaine. He's called Leas and Oxus. But anyway, I will talk to the rest of you in the morning and pick a specialization. So I will see you guys bright and early.